Molly rolling up a penny. She just wanna taste the candy. Probably soaking up her panties. Nasty when she off the bust a move on Marco Angie. I just went and bought a planet. Now that shit was never planted. Yeah, 12-figure skate plan.
What is up, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. So today is a long-awaited video. People have probably been wondering why I haven't done this yet, but I was waiting to get my crank up done. That's right, today is the boot mode video. I'm tuning my car with boot mode. Now, I do already have my tune downloaded to the car, but I haven't tried anything. I just turned it off, and I'm actually gonna go through and do the flashing process again, because I do want to make some changes to my burbles and stuff. I got them set, you know, how they come with the 93 stage one off the shelf map. So I want to go in there and make them a little bit more aggressive for this first time around. I've never had them, so I do want to be a little kid for a little bit with the burbles. Also, one thing I want to show you, I feel like I finally dialed in my rear fitment. I put a 10 millimeter spacer back there and it looks perfect. It looks perfect in my opinion, that is. I don't know, you guys let me know what you think. All right, anyways, guys. So I'm gonna show you what I got for boot mode. So I am a cheapo and I got this OBD2 to iPhone with an adapter off of Amazon. I don't want to spend $100 on boot mode's little thing that's just some plastic piece from China that you could probably get. It's generic, they printed their thing on it. It's a little expensive if you ask me, so I got this. All right, everybody, you want to plug this obviously into your OBD2 port. Shout out to my friend Hannah, you're the reason why I made my first YouTube video. And I did, I think, a coding video on the headlights where I had the little Bluetooth adapter. And you were like, you didn't even tell where to plug in the Bluetooth adapter. Shout out to you, but I think most of us know. You're not gonna be able to get an off-brand Bluetooth one in to actually have it work. After you get that plugged in, you wanna plug this into your phone, obviously. Now, the car is not on, but you want to put on your seatbelt. After you have your seatbelt on, you want to put the car into accessory mode by taking your foot off of the brake and hitting the start-stop button one time. Also, if you have this OBD2 cord, you're going to want to take your Wi-Fi and turn it off if you have CarPlay, because that's going to mess it up. So now I'm going to screen record and I'm going to go to BOOTMOD3, the app. See, it's connected. I'm gonna hit start. So now that you're in the app, you're gonna wanna go over here. You're gonna go to maps, my maps. As you can see, I have a stage 1 93 octane map. And the other thing that I did was transmission. I downloaded the GTS transmission flash. And from what I hear, it works wonders, but I guess we're gonna find out. So I have those two done. Now it's saying my OBD2 is not connected. Let's see here. Go to maps again. Stage 1 93 octane. All you have to do is go down to settings in the right hand corner and then hit flash, and it'll flash it for you. So also, once you're in map details of the map that you want to download, you can go up here to the top right hand corner to settings, and you can see exhaust burble type, GTS star uproar, max cooling mode, catalytic heating, so you can turn your cold start on or off, electronic wastegate disable, T-map sensor, exhaust or T-map sensor, intake manifold, exhaust flap, you can have it open. There's all kinds of stuff, catalytic monitors, which means your check engine light. That's something that you want to probably turn off once you get downpipes, because it's going to throw a code if you get downpipes, and you'll be able to control that with boot mode. Anti-lag customization, I mean, it's torque by gear. It's endless what you can do with this, which is why I wanted it. And I do plan on doing some better, probably getting with like F80 Paul and doing some custom stuff with my car once it's ready. I just wanted to get used to using boot mode. I wanted to get used to the platform before I started really going crazy. So exhaust burble type. As you can see in sport, I have, which I didn't mean to turn it up like that. In sport, I have it set really low. Duration in sport plus is pretty decently high. I'm gonna turn that down just to like 3.2. So aggression in sport is 6.9. I'll turn that down just a little bit. I want to be able to like put it in sport and then not have to worry about it too much. Okay. So now, aggression sport plus, I'll keep that pretty high. So minimum RPM is 1200. Let's keep that. And then it says max RPM is 5600. I want to go up a little bit higher than that. Let's go up to like 65. That means they'll still burble at that high of RPMs, you know, if you're downshifting or whatever. So that's pretty much how I want. As you can see, you can go OEM, OTS, original, you can turn it off, you can do GTS, ZCP. Like I pretty much just wanted to figure this out, so I'm just gonna start playing with it. But now that I have that ready, I can actually go, and it actually says that there's an update. See if my settings saved. Yeah, so the settings are still on here, which now I can actually go and flash it. It's saying that I need to download this update. So I can now flash this. It says battery charger is highly recommended. This doesn't actually take that long, and it's not that big of a deal if you have a good battery, if you know you have a good battery. But anyways, I'm just going to go ahead and do it because I'm not worried about it. I'm going to hit flash. And as you can see, it's now flashing the car. You're going to get drivetrain malfunctions, chassis stabilization, drive moderately, collision warning. Don't worry, it does this and then it all goes away. But we're flashing the tune now, and it won't take long at all, as you can see, if you've already flashed your car. All right, it says done successfully. Now what you're gonna do is you're gonna let all of these codes and warnings disappear from your dash and your iDrive system. And now you're gonna cut the car off. You're gonna give it a few seconds. I usually give it, it says to give it 5, but I just, you know, give it a little bit longer just in case. I think it's been long enough. You'll be able to hear the GTS startup roar. My neighbors are gonna freaking hate me, but I could not help myself. It sounds insane. Holy shit. There's no way I'm not getting in trouble with this. I guess we gotta go on a drive now. You know, my neighbors did call the cops on me one time. Ah, finally I can control my valves. That is one of the coolest parts about this, is that you can control your valves. Thank you. are gonna hate me so much. All right, you gotta put your foot on the gas to keep it from burbling. So keep a steady foot on the gas at a steady RPM for it not to burble in your neighborhood. That was kind of crazy. That one was kind of crazy. Especially considering that the police department is right there. I think they were talking about me. Road so bad. The GTS transmission flash is so worth it. Like, it's a little bit less aggressive feeling, but it shifts so much faster. Like, I feel like before it was being overly aggressive just to give you the feeling like the transmission was doing so much work. It takes out a little bit of that, and it makes it feel like the transmission is just more precise. It shifts exactly when you want it to. It's a lot better than the OEM. And I have noticed that in first gear, it's not as jerky, so that's a plus. This thing is insane right now. Holy crap, it definitely feels like more horsepower. There it goes. Stock charge pipes on this car, which I know is ballsy. How do you do $4,000 crank cup job without doing your charge pipes first? That's just me. That's just how I am. You know, it's kind of like get the big stuff done, then the small stuff, and then like in between there, I make the mistake of saying, "Hey, my crank cup's done. I can tune my car peacefully now." Burbles, you know, like that's just how I am. So I'm happy with this right now, like. Stage one's plenty enough for me. If the car comes with 430-ish horsepower, 435 or whatever it is, and you put a 70, you know, horsepower tune on there, which, let's be honest, it's never what they say it is. So I'm going to go ahead and guess this car probably is around anywhere between 480 and 500 horsepower with this tune. Now, if I'm wrong, correct me, but it says the Stage 1 93 tune off the shelf map. Is a 70 horsepower flash. So it could be, it could not be. I don't know, but let me know what you think. I mean, am I like around 480, 500 in there? It definitely feels like 500. The torque is just crazy. Like, I'd gotten used to the car. You know, whenever I first bought the car, of course it felt insanely fast. And then I got used to it where it felt kind of sluggish, and now it feels like a whole different car. The shifts are lightning fast. I mean, I'm obsessed with it, dude. Well, this is just absolutely great, guys. I don't know what's wrong with my car. I'm driving it being rowdy, and it's just like you can feel it kind of missing. what do you know, it throws a drivetrain malfunction. So I guess we'll figure out what we're looking at.
Temperatures are normal. I'm gonna let the car cool off and then I'm gonna check for coolant in my charge cooler to make sure that that is not blown, because this is my third one. I don't know why I haven't bought an upgraded one yet. That was stupid. But yeah, we'll figure out if the drivetrain malfunction goes away. The car is not in limp mode, so whatever it is, it can't be that bad, I don't think. The car was driving normal, but man, I tell myself don't tune the car. Don't tune it because it's gonna get shit wrong with it. Hilarious. Comical. If anything was gonna happen to it, which I'm fully prepared to replace, but if anything was gonna happen to it, I would have for sure thought it would be the charge pipe break. So if I get out of here without another drivetrain malfunction, I guess I will probably just take it easy on the car, maybe even flash it back to stock. I'm loving the burbles, like I finally got to hear them while the car is warm, so they're pretty gnarly. I'd probably have to tune them back a little bit, but oh, you live and you learn. What a beautiful day to be alive too, because it is just gorgeous out here. Late summer, early fall, beautiful weather. I'm gonna let the car cool off, but fuck. I found the culprit to my problem. It is the charge cooler. I just got the crank up done on this car, and they told me that the one I had was leaking. They wanted to sell me a CSF one. I don't know if they put one on here. They said they tested one and put it on here, and that it worked. And they charged me $100 for a used one, which was fine with me. I don't know if they forgot to put coolant back in it. Bone dry smoke coming out of it. My charge cooler is hot as shit. Like, I would have been down to buy, you know, something other than CSF. I'm not paying $2,000 for some bullshit like that. That's just a name. I'm not doing it. I guess I'm gonna have a new charge cooler on the way. Drivetrain malfunction is gone. Okay. So that indicates that it's dry running. In fact, I'm just gonna cut the car off and let it cool down completely. All right, I wanted to give an update about the charge cooler. I got home, I put coolant in the car, I bled it, I put coolant in it again. I drove it pretty hard for a while and it's been fine, it feels great. And if you open the hood after driving hard and you touch the charge cooler, it's still cool to the touch. I don't know if it's leaking out slowly or if they just forgot to put coolant in there, which is what I'm hoping happened, so I don't have to put a new one in it right now. I guess we'll see. I guess I'll find out in a few days. I've only had the car back for like a week. I haven't driven it much, so I know it takes a while for it to get to the point where it throws a drivetrain malfunction. This has happened to me before with the OEM charge cooler. They are just prone to breaking, so hopefully they didn't put a broken one on my car. And yeah, the tune is awesome. I'm gonna go home, probably wash this thing and get ready for tomorrow. It is what it is. But anyways, guys, I'll keep you updated, but the car is fine for right now, so I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.